And now we will learn how a landlord could use a management company and record related transactions. What does a property management company do for you? Well, they collect rent from the tenants. They pay the property-related expenses from the rent they collect, and they give the remainder to the property owner, and then they deduct a small fee from that payout for their own little services that they provide for you. What information does a property management company give you as they provide this service? Well, they give you a statement for every time they pay the property owner. The statement lists each tenant's rent collected on that statement. And then the statement lists all the expenses that were paid by the management company from that collected rent. It also indicates the fee that they subtracted from the collected rent before they gave you the payout. The net amount on the statement should match the amount paid, whether they wrote you a check or did a direct deposit into your bank account. What do you need to record in QuickBooks? Well, when you read from the statement, you should record each tenant's rent payment into the Receive Payments window one by one. This gives you the ability to keep track of who owes you money, regardless of whether the management company is keeping track of it or not. When doing so, which means when you record each tenant's payment one by one, you must make sure to choose the undeposited funds account as the deposit to account. This is true even if the management company directly deposited the money into your bank account. It's just a bookkeeping procedure that QuickBooks needs to do, but you will see it will make the entire statement that you enter very easy. Use the Make Deposits window to record all expenses, including the management fees deducted from the payment from the management company. So, before our example, let's add the property management fees expense to the chart of accounts. So we come here and we click List, Chart of Accounts. In the bottom left, we click Account, New. This is an expense, and we'll put it in capital letters. Property management, In this course, spelling doesn't count. Property. Okay, well, what have we got to do? Now, save and close, and now we have an expense that we can track how much we pay the management company for the service, or more specifically, how much they took out of our rent for the service. We also have to add the name of the company to the vendor list. In this case, it's Vonda Vixen's Property Management Corp. They're the company we pay the expense to. So we go to the vendor, vendor center, new vendor, and we type in Vonda Vixen's Property Management. And again, in this course, spelling doesn't count. Now we're really ready to dive into it. Here's the example. September 1, we employed Vonda Vixen Management to collect all September rent and pay all expenses from the collected rent. September 30, Vonda has finished collecting September rent and has already paid some expenses related to the property. So, September 30, she deposits directly into Holden's bank account the net amount of the rent minus expenses and the management fees. She gave you the following deposit statement to enter. And here it is, and we're going to enter this directly. Now remember, first record each tenant's payment one by one, and then make sure you choose the undeposited funds account when doing so. Then use the Make Deposits window to put in the rest. So let's read from this. We can close these windows. We can open the payment window, and we know that this is September of 2020. So we can put, you know, whatever you have to do to get the right date. Oh, excuse me, September September 30th, because that's the day we collected the rent. Okay, now remember, we're not doing cash in bank. As part of this bookkeeping procedure that's special for management company, we have to use undeposited funds. Then we choose Al and Arby, and we know we got $2,000 from him. Make sure that he goes into the proper receivables account because he always pays in advance. Save and new. Who else? I'll click OK. Who else did we collect for? Betty Boop, $1,000. No problem. Betty Boop. You know, you can leave the date and the undeposited funds, and then you just put it here. Again, remember, make sure you put it in the right receivables account, but we're not focusing on that anymore. But anyway, it's $1,000. So whatever invoices it gets applied to, don't worry. We'll just click save and close and click okay. Oh, okay. Oops, we closed it. That means we got to reset. Oh, it remembers the date. Who was the third one? The third tenant was Candy Charles in this example. Candy Charles. And we know she's $1,000 a month. And we know that she pays in advance. So she's unearned rental income, and we make sure it's undeposited funds, and then that's all you have to do. Save and close and click OK. Now we've recorded the three payments that we collected from tenants or the management company. Now we're going to not only record these three expenses, but we're also going to acknowledge that this money has been placed into the bank account net of these expenses. From the main menu, click Banking, Make Deposit. Notice two windows open up. The first window is just for you to confirm that all of the deposits that were shown on the statement were entered properly. So you double check that by clicking the check mark in the left margin. This tells QuickBooks that they all have been deposited on the same date. Click OK, and now we're at the most important window, the make deposit window. Now we will read the expenses one by one. We can see the first one is Rex repair, fix the gate. So directly under the last payment, we click the next row, we choose Rex repair, and then we choose repair expense. And of course, when we click to put the money amount, we have to put a minus. Then we push tab and notice the total expense, or the total deposit rather, decreases by the amount of the negative number. The next one that the report says, or the statement says, is that we cleaned a spill for Betty Boop. Now, if the tenant is named rather than the vendor, we have to put the tenant. Just click OK for the warning and don't worry. We put the tenant so that it will match it on the profit and loss by tenant or profit and loss by apartment report. We know that that's cleaning expense, and we know to put in a negative number, and we push tab on our keyboard to save the amount in the field. The last thing we have to put is the expense deducted, management fee by Vonda. So no problem. We choose Vonda from the bottom of the vendor list, and we put in the new expense that we made, property management fees, and of course that will be a negative number, and we push tab. Notice after we enter all the expenses as a negative number, the net deposit equals the amount in the statement. Now all we have to do is make sure the deposit window has the right date so it matches it to the bank account. Because when we get a bank statement, it's going to say that this was deposited on September 30 of 2020. Now that every item in the deposit window looks exactly like every item in the statement from the property management company, then you would click Save and Close.